Okay. Rag, I'm missing Walking Dead. Just give me a moment if anybody's here. Xbox, Switch. Oh, geez, it's gonna take a while. I forgot the last time I played this was on my 360, so I might be sick of my 360 account. Just wait for this to sink. It's sinking right now, but you guys can't see it. There we go. Alright, so let's play. We're gonna play from the very beginning. Ah, I forgot I did 400 days. Let's do a new game here. Turn off UI hint help. I'll keep it on for now. It's been a while since I played this game. Alright, let's get this. Get this on the roll. I love this game. I remember when it first came out, I was like, what is this? Because of the graphics and how, like, you know, comic book-like it was. But I gave it a shot since it had the Walking Dead name in it. And it surprised me. I think the year it came out, I got Game of the Year. Okay. Episode 1, A New Day. Poor Lee. This whole story is just sad with him. It's a Walking Dead. What do you expect? It's gonna be sad. Can I help you?
Well, I reckon you didn't do it then.
Excuse me? Why do you say that?
You know, I've driven a bunch of fellas down to this prison. Lord knows how many. Usually it's about now I get the, I didn't do it.
And what do you say?
I say, yep, I know you didn't.
And yeah, I guess you believe him, don't you? Let's play I Spy, huh? A house. Oh, pass it. Never mind. Okay, looking there.
I followed your case a little bit. You being a making boy and all.
You've got an opinion then?
Wouldn't say that. I go in for that innocent till proven guilty thing. Even considering who they say you killed.
Any of that seem important to you?
All of it, but that box never shuts up. Sit in this seat and pay too much attention and you'll drive yourself crazy.
Maybe you should pay attention this time.
UGA. You teach there long?
Going on my 6th year.
You meet your wife in Athens? You want to know how
yeah.
I see it?
Anybody who's watching who does not know the story, Lee ended up, killing his wife?
Sure.
I think. No, never mind. He didn't kill the wife. He killed the guy she was cheating on with.
Could be you just married the wrong woman.
I'm gonna try to play exactly the way I would respond. Like, I wouldn't want
to
be mean to him.
Stop worrying about things you can't control.
I mean, she did cheat on him, so it's like maybe he did marry the wrong woman.
I'm driving this man once. He was the worst one. He wouldn't stop going on about how he didn't do it. He was an older fella, big soft eyes behind a pair of smart folk glasses. And he just wailing back there. Says it wasn't him. Crying and snotting all over right where you're sitting. Then before long,
should you really
he starts
turn it off?
Kicking the back of the seat like a fussy baby on an airplane. And I tell him he's got to stop. But that's government property, and I'll be forced to zap him.
Maybe
otherwise.
You should look forward in front of the
so
road.
He stops, and having exhausted all his options, he starts crying out for his mama. Mama! It's all a big mistake. It wasn't me.
So did he do it?
Did he do it?
They caught the fucker red-handed, stabbing his wife, cutting her up as the boys came through the door. He sits in my car screaming bloody murder that it wasn't him. I think he actually believed it himself. It goes to show, people will up and go mad when they believe their life is over. I got another
I guess that's true. Oh gosh.
This one's a little bit less
buddy in front of you.
A bit more hilarious if I do say so.
Watch out.
This other time.
The one thing is funny. I think it's funny how the zombie apocalypse is just now starting, and the zombies already look like they're decaying like crazy. But I guess it's for the effects of the game. So that way you definitely know that it's a zombie. Okay. Kick this window out and get out. Wake up, Lee, wake up. It's fine. He'll be alright.
From the car during the wreck.
Okay.
He's not moving.
All right.
Must have the handcuff keys on him.
Yeah, that's right. Oh, I can turn around. Duh. All right. Kick out this window. Kick it out. Crawl out, Lee. Go, go, go. Crawl out. Careful with the glass. Okay, let's go inspect this guy.
Officer? God damn. Officer?
Ah. Had to walk like 2 more feet. Get his keys. Oh gosh. Get these cuffs off. And watch this guy come back to life. Oh, there he is. Starting to twitch. Crawl, crawl, Lee, crawl. That gun. Alright, got the gun. Yeah, gotta get the shell. Oh gosh, go Lee, go. Oh, come on, Lee. I remember when I first played this, it was so suspenseful, this part. I was like, oh my gosh, what do I do? Not like I ever died here, but still, like, it was a little suspenseful.
Man.
Come on, Lee, he doesn't count for murder. He's already dead.
His skin's all rotten and he smells like shit.
See, how do they decay so fast? That doesn't make any sense to me. And I shot him. All right. I like the comic look, but I wish they would make a game that's a little bit more realistic, like looking. I guess it would cost more, and I think Telltale's. Even though they make the games look, you know, pretty much. I think they're more of a budget company. Holy, go, go, go. Jump that fence. They all just come out of nowhere. I can't wait for season 7 of The Walking Dead by the end of this year, I think. When does it come out? Yeah, I think a few more months, and then we'll have the new season. But anybody's been caught up, there was a crazy, or it's not caught up actually. Anybody? There's a crazy cliffhanger, and it just got stuck there, and how dare they do that?
Fill one of those teacups with some bourbon if I could.
That's where we meet Clem. Let's go inside the building or house.
Help!
I probably wouldn't be screaming.
Hello? Anybody home? I need a little help.
Alright, breaking and entering.
Don't shoot, okay? Ah, shit. Hello? I'm not an intruder. Or one of them.
These people might need more help than I do.
Fruit?
It's fake. Damn.
Aww. Well, you better watch out for that.
Jesus.
You're gonna slip on it. You saw it and you slipped. Okay. A walkie.
The Marsh House. That's a Savannah. But that's the type of note you'd leave a babysitter.
Savannah. Savannah.
What's that?
Just drink a random cup that's there. Alright, let's answer that phone
there
that keeps beeping.
New messages. Message 1, left at 5:43 p.m.
Hey, Sandra, this is Diana. We're still in Savannah. Ed had a little incident with some crazy guy near the hotel, so we had to get him back to the ER and have it checked out.
You mean
anyway,
a zombie?
He's not feeling well enough to drive back tonight, so we're staying an extra day. Thanks so much for looking after Clementine, and I promise we'll be back in time before your spring break.
Message 2, left at 11:19.
Oh my god, finally. I don't know if you tried to reach us. All the calls are getting dropped. They're not letting us leave and aren't telling us anything about Atlanta. Please, please, just leave the city and take Clementine with you back to Murrieta. I've got to get back to the hospital. Please let me know that you're safe.
Message 3, left at 6:51 a.m.
Looks fresh.
Clementine, baby. If you can hear this, call the police. That's 911. We love you. We love you. We love you.
This game's so sad. Like, it falls on the footsteps of the show and also the comic itself.
Daddy?
Huh? Hello?
Yes, your father.
You need to be quiet.
Who is this? Well, I know who it is, so...
I'm okay. They tried to get me. But I'm hiding until my parents come home.
What's your name? Even though I know, I don't know why I asked that.
I'm Clementine. This is my house.
Hi, Clementine. I'm Lee. How old are you?
8.
And you're all alone?
Yes.
I actually really like season 2 a little bit more. Since you see her get to grow up and stuff. She's a little bit older.
37.
Okay.
Okay.
Where are your parents?
They took a trip and left me with Sandra. They're in Savannah, I think, where the boats are.
Where are you?
I'm outside in my treehouse. They can't get in.
That's smart.
See? Can you see me? I can see you through the window.
Where did you come from? I searched the whole house. Two times he slipped on that blood. Punch her in the face. Come on, you need to give me the hammer immediately. Immediately. Go. X. Clem, hammer. Give me that. Hit her in the face. Multiple times. Go. Go, eat. Go. Oh, yeah. That's what you get. She looks better now.
Man. Hi there.
What up, Clem?
Did you kill it?
I think it was already dead, but yes.
I think something else did. Before me, I think.
I heard her scream 2 nights ago. Maybe one of the monsters got her.
2 nights ago? Yeah, that's probably what happened. You've been all by yourself through this?
Yeah, I want my parents to come home now.
I think that might be a little while, you know?
Oh.
Look, I don't know what happened, but I'll look after you until then.
I know we just met,
what should
but
we do now?
I'll be your father figure. You look for help before it gets dark. Sounds like a better idea.
Before it gets dark.
Yeah, it's not safe at night.
Let's go. Stay close to me.
Alright, let's go. Can't wait till he gets his leg fixed so he doesn't limp around so slow. He's like a walker himself.
Oh man. I ain't never getting home to Mama at this rate. This sucks. Oh, it's hot dish night.
What's the matter?
Should I stay?
What?
I don't want to sleep in the treehouse tonight, but I don't know if I should leave. What if my parents come home?
They're not. Sorry to let you know that.
I won't leave you alone.
Let's go somewhere safe that's close, okay?
That's a good idea.
Hey, man!
Holy shit!
Don't eat us!
We're not gonna hurt you.
Yeah. Thought for a second you and the little one were both gonna give us the chomp.
What are you doing?
Trying to get home. This neighborhood's a disaster. Are you trying to get out of here? Because you should be. Those things are all over the damn place. I haven't seen anything as gnarly as this neighborhood since downtown Atlanta, 15 miles back. I'm Sean. Sean Green.
Lee, this is Clementine.
I'm Chet.
That's Herschel's son.
We shouldn't be out in the open like this. How about you help us clear the way, and we'll take you and your daughter out of here and down to my family's farm. It should be safer there.
I'm not gonna lie to anybody. There you go.
Just some guy.
Some guy?
Yeah.
She's alone? Let's get going. Staying put for too long is a mistake.
What do you want to do?
The funny thing is, later when I meet Herschel, he, like, even if you tell him the truth about everything, I think he, like, says, like, you're lying or something. And I'm like, no, I said the truth the whole time. Push, push, push. One more time, one big heave. Come on, Clem. Go. Again? Okay, no, no, no. We got it.
For just some guy, it seems like you saved a bunch of lives today.
That does sound like a really good place to be, though. A farm. As long as this is obviously secured, but I don't know. The TV show kind of showed that not work, but hey, at least Sean, you have like plenty of food, right? If you grow everything.
My mom was going to be in a snit.
No sweat, man. I'll catch you tomorrow night.
It was nice to meet you both.
Thank God you're okay.
That's Herschel.
I was worried it'd be bad here, too.
Been quiet as usual the past couple days. Old Brecken down the way thinks his mare's gone lame, but that ain't nothing new.
I wouldn't have made it back without Chet.
Well, I'm glad you took him with you, then. You've brought a couple guests.
We, need a place to stay.
You're welcome to stay here, but just for the night. I don't run a bed and breakfast. So it's just you and your daughter, then?
Oh, not his daughter. He's, well, just some guy who found her alone.
Honey, do you know this man?
Yes.
Okay, then. Well,
he's usually the one that lied. It's not me.
You hurt your leg pretty bad there.
Yeah, it's not doing so good.
I can help you out. Sean, run on in and check on your sister. You, take a seat up on the porch and I'll go see what I have. Let's have a look. Yeah, this is swollen to hell.
Could be worse.
That's what it sounds like. Seems like things got awful bad in the cities. What did you say your name was?
It's Lee.
Nice to meet you, Lee. I'm Herschel Green. How'd this happen?
Car accident.
That's so. Where are you headed before the car accident?
I was getting out of Atlanta.
The news says stay.
Yeah, well, that's a mistake. We hit a guy. One of those things you've been hearing about. On the road.
Who are you with, the girl?
I was with a police officer.
See, I'm not going to lie to him. I don't feel like that's, that'll be right.
Nice of him.
I'm an awful nice guy.
House is full up with mine. We got another displaced family of three sleeping in the barn. You and your daughter are welcome to rest there, and we're done here. I didn't catch your name, darling.
Clementine.
Can't imagine what you've been through, Clementine.
Looking after her until we find her parents.
Hey, Dad, so I'm thinking, first thing tomorrow, we gotta reinforce the fence around the farm.
That doesn't seem necessary.
I don't know what you saw on TV or heard.
How's that not necessary?
There's some serious shit hitting the fan. I don't think anyone knows how big it is yet.
Her face is like, oh my god, you said a bad word.
Your son is right. You're going to want to fortify this place.
Stuff like that doesn't happen around here, Sean.
Dad, I'm serious. Lee, come on. Tell him what you saw out there, man.
I got chased by a couple of dead people.
Well, do what you think you should. We got plenty of chores as it is.
Lee and those folks in the barn can
so ignorant. Like, he doesn't think anything bad will happen to his home. That's also exactly how he did it in the show, and obviously the comics, which this is more based off of.
If your leg gets hot or the swelling doesn't go down, you're probably dealing with an infection.
What do we do then?
We'll probably just have to shoot you.
Huh.
We'll clean it, redress it, and you'll be fine.
Okay, that'd be preferable.
I mean, you could just cut off my leg.
There's such in the barn. We'll be seeing you bright and early. Come tomorrow, which way you think you're headed?
Towards Macon, I suppose. All right, then.
It smells like...
manure.
Manure.
Manure? Like when a horse plops?
Just like that.
I missed my mom and dad.
I bet, Clem.
How far is Savannah?
Pretty far.
Oh, okay.
We'll get there.
Hey, get up.
I'm itchy.
Well, you slept in a barn, little lady. Lucky you don't have spiders in your hair. But I bet your daddy scared them all away, huh?
I'm, not her dad. Name's Lee.
I'm Kenny.
Dad, we're in the middle of a fence. There's a tractor and everything.
We better get going, or we won't hear
the
end
of it. I hate this one so much. It's just so annoying.
That's my boy, Ken Jr. We call him Duck, though.
Doc?
Yeah, nothing bothers him. Like water off a duck's back, you know?
That's a valuable treat lately.
No kidding. But frankly, I think it's because he's dumb as a bag of hammers.
Dad!
But he makes up for it with enthusiasm.
It's so annoying.
The word is, you were on your way to Macon.
My family's from there.
Well, Macon's on the way, and personally, I'd appreciate the company of a guy who can knock a couple of heads together if he has to.
Oh, I'm sorry. I missed it.
Honey,
I don't know why.
Doc, this is Lee. And what's the girl's name?
Clementine.
Clementine.
That is a very pretty name.
Thanks.
Well, we should get to work. We've all seen what those things can do out there, so the faster we get this fence up, the better.
I want to build a fence.
Yeah? Well, I need a good foreman. You can sit on the tractor and yell at me whenever I take a water break.
On the tractor? Cool!
Duck and I will hop to it.
Oh, that duck is so annoying. I just hate his face.
We can visit.
Alright, give me control. Find out a little bit more about these people.
Hey there, girls. You two actually look relaxed.
I think we're doing just fine. Clementine was just telling me about first grade.
Oh, how's that?
It's easy.
Well, yeah. So, you're good?
Anyway, it's almost like we didn't see people eating each other for the past 3 days. It's peaceful here, no?
How was the city?
How did you handle getting through the city?
Kenny just drove. We passed so many people that needed help, and we just passed people over some.
It's okay. It's fine. You don't have to say anymore.
I want to go home tomorrow, but even then I can't take away the things Doc went through. Don't you want to go back to the moment before you knew about all of this?
Things were bad before. Bad now, but they're different, you see?
People are eating each other.
But they weren't before. The banks, the politics, the crap. Those things are gone. Hell comes in a lot of different colors.
That's true.
So, what do you do when corpses aren't walking around?
I'm a veterinarian back in Fort Lauderdale, like Herschel here, except more with dogs and cats and not horses. What is it that you do, Lee?
I used to teach up at the University of Georgia.
We need to hope that we can go back to our jobs soon, Lee. Back to normal. It can't stay like this.
Yeah, my mistake.
We'll all be home soon.
Back in a bit.
Okay, Lee.
Let's go find more out about Kenny. Working on a truck, yep.
It's not the most reliable pickup in the world, but it gets the job done.
Hey there, Kenny. Need any help?
No, I think I got it. Do you need any help?
What do you mean?
I mean in taking care of that little girl. You know what you're doing? You got kids of your own?
I think I've got it handled okay. As long as I keep her safe, I think I'm doing all right.
With those things out there, maybe. Sure, that's enough. But you gotta ask yourself if you're the type of guy who can do better than that if her parents don't show up.
I'll keep that in mind.
I'll be fine.
How's your son doing?
Good, I think. Kachi's got a sister up in Memphis. We were coming back from visiting her. We were in a gas station and some guy grabbed my boy. I thought he was kidnapping him. I was on the fucker in about 2 seconds and... Christ. Just lucky I was there. We saw a lot of bodies before we stumbled upon Herschel's. But we're a tough family, Lee. Ain't nothing gonna faze us.
So what's your
plan, bro? What are you gonna do?
Get down to Lauderdale and let this mess get sorted out. Government'll start handing out shots, and the National Guard'll do its thing. On the odd chance things got too bad, we could hop on my boat, I guess.
You've got a boat.
I'm a commercial fisherman, catching mackerel, dolphin, whatever's biting and paying. Kachi wouldn't be wild about it, but the boat's not that bad.
See you.
Yeah, I think a boat's not bad, but then right now we're watching Fear the Walking Dead, they're on a boat, and bad things are happening.
Hey, Lee.
Need a hand?
That'd be great. If you could cut those 2x to length, that'd sure speed things up.
Nah.
My dad doesn't know how bad it is.
No, he doesn't.
I saw a guy in Atlanta kill a kid. A boy. Just shot him right in the face.
Was the boy one of the walkers?
I don't even know. He was either attacking the guy or asking for help. He didn't even hesitate. He just turned, put the barrel of the gun right between the kid's eyes. And pull the trigger. You don't see things like that. It's not like in the movies.
They don't fall like you think.
Did you have to do it?
Do what?
Kill. Have you had to off one yet?
It's not killing.
I had to shoot one.
I mean, they're already dead.
I could shoot one. Maybe. If it were far away. I'm just glad we're getting this fence built.
Well, if that's the case, you're not going to survive long, are you?
And thinks inviting people in is a bigger threat than whatever's out there. How about yours? How's your family?
I'd rather not talk about it. Well, I guess my family. Not my wife.
Oh, man. I hope so, too. Maybe it's not too bad there. That's probably all I need cut for now.
Thanks. It's worse than you think, actually. The whole world is probably messed up.
And Sean, thanks again for the ride.
No problem, Lee. Couldn't leave you behind. Anyway, when you see my dad around, he might want some help in the barn.
The child's annoying, but I'm gonna go talk to Duck. I hate this kid so much.
How you doing, Duck?
Good. I'm gonna drive the tractor.
Bet you are.
Lift with your back, Sean.
I hate you so much.
How'd you get out of Atlanta?
I was on my way out anyway. Timing of all this just happened to be right.
If there ever is a good time for the supposed apocalypse.
This farm's a nice plot of land.
Had you told me 20 years ago I'd still be doing this, I would have told you that you were full of crap. Never was a plan, having a place like this. It was in the family, and I guess so was I. Family's important. It's all that matters. You agree with that?
Was brought up to, yes.
Where's your family now?
Parents,
wife, girlfriend?
My parents are in Macon.
With my brother.
Well, I hope they're all right.
Me too, actually.
Now you've got this little girl to take care of. Clementine, is it? You just stumbled up on her?
I was looking for help, yeah. See, I haven't lied to him once. But this part, right here, doesn't change.
Sure.
I don't know who you are or what you did, but you better become a better liar, and fast.
See, I'm not lying. I don't get this part.
Get better back in the cities, or they get worse before they do. You're going to have to depend on the honesty of strangers if you're going to make it. And if those same people get to questioning yours, you're going to be in trouble. So whoever you are and whatever you did, keep it to your damn self. But at least you have the common sense to listen to a man giving you advice.
But I didn't lie.
Go! I'll get my gun!
Now this part, I feel like we could have saved both of them. But I'm going to, even though I hate Duck, I'm going to go save Duck here. Only because, either way, Sean dies, and Duck is Kenny's son, so I need to get respect from Kenny. We could easily run over to Sean right now. Plenty of time right there. Either way that happens though, if I end up helping him or not. You ran over after, like you were carrying a shotgun.
Sorry. Look at him.
Sorry is no damn good.
Please, just go.
Get out and never come back. He
You've got that ride to Macon if you want it. This is as far as we're going.
Then it's far enough.
Look!
Hey there! You friendly?
You don't do
trucks
that.
Run out of gas.
That's not what you do in a zombie apocalypse.
Fuck!
We're trapped! No!
Go, guys. Glenn.
We can't take risks like this. And we can't just let people die either. When I say that door stays shut no matter what, I fucking mean it. We don't know who these people are. They could be dangerous.
Worse, they could have led them right to us.
Where the hell is your humanity?
We have kids with us.
I see one little girl.
What is it?
I have to pee.
I'd go out there again in a second.
I bet you would.
In a minute, Clem.
They've got kids, Lily.
Those things outside don't care.
Maybe you should go join them then. You'll have something in common.
God damn it, Lily. You have to control these people.
Carly and Glenn just ran out there.
She's not wrong. They took a risk.
Yes, we did.
And we appreciate it. Now let's settle down.
Holy shit.
I hate him. I hate him so much, too. Just a dick.
He wasn't bitten.
Hell, he wasn't.
He wasn't.
We have to end this now.
Over my dead body. We'll dig one.
He needs
hole.
To settle down. Like, it's easy to, like, just clean him up and see if there's a bite on him.
Don't you fucking people get it? We've already seen this happen. We let someone with a bite stay
and it takes time.
We all end up
it takes time to turn, at least in this world.
We gotta throw him out.
Not like 28 days later where it's like instant.
Stop him!
What do we do about this guy?
Dad, it's just a boy. It's...
Lily, I'll handle this.
But your heart, Dad. You need to calm down.
This is a new group. We need to make sure that we reason with him.
An axe handle, maybe. Nobody
threatens. I did sign with him.
Everyone chill the fuck out!
Nobody is doing anything.
Shut up, Lily. And you, shut the fuck up. They will find us, and they will get in here. And none of this will fucking matter. But right now, we're about to be trapped in here with one of those things.
What the hell are you talking about?
He's bitten! That's how you turn!
He's not bitten. Lee,
or you die
this.
And you turn.
Stop upsetting him.
Ooh,
but they find out later.
Upsetting is getting eaten alive.
Sit down. That's it.
You're gonna whoop me? You and what homo parade? This one. That's good. Little boy, before you eat your mommy, you can watch your dad get his nose broken.
I'm gonna kill him, Cat. Just worry about Duck.
Lee.
Yeah?
There's someone in there.
It's just locked. Key's behind the counter. Probably.
He just knows.
Hey, I'm not the bad guy here. I'm just looking out for my daughter.
No, you're just the guy arguing for killing a kid.
He's covered in muck. She'll find the bite. Watch.
She won't. And if she does, the first thing he'll do is sink his teeth into his mom's face. Then, once she's dead, he'll probably pounce on your little girl.
It's a little boy. I think we can handle it.
A little boy? He'll be an uncontrollable man-eater.
It's not gonna happen.
It is. And we're tossing him out now!
Knock this guy out.
Happily.
Jesus!
Oh, man.
Jesus!
Clementine! Oh, I forgot his leg is still injured.
Get away from her, you son of a bitch!
Why'd you pick him up from the ground? I would have stomped in his face. Okay.
Man.
You okay?
Just great, thanks.
Guys?
His face.
They're gonna get in. Shut up.
He's so negative.
Is that the military?
I don't know.
Thank God for whatever it is. We almost died because of this bitch and Richie Triggerfinger. That was stupid. That was.
Dad.
Heart pain.
What's wrong with it?
It's his heart.
My pills.
Nitroglycerin pills? Yes, we're out. We've been trying to get into the pharmacy since we got here. Please try to get in there. Behind the counter where the pills are.
We'll get in there somehow.
Thank
Even though
he's so
an ass,
much.
I can't let him just suffer.
We need nitroglycerin pills. Please get in there. I'll keep an eye on my dad.
Everyone else should get comfy and look for anything useful. We could be in here a while.
I'm starting to think this drugstore isn't a permanent solution.
You're right. This ain't exactly Fort Knox.
What do you suggest?
We need as much gas as possible so we can all get out of downtown Macon. Fast.
Agreed.
And I'll head out.
Len's always right.
There's a motel not too far from here, out towards the end of Peachtree. I'll work my way towards it and then loop back, siphoning what I can.
Damn, that'd be great.
Well, it's gotta get done. Plus, I'm quick. And I know Macon.
Local?
Born and raised.
If you're gonna do that, here's a walkie-talkie if you get in a tight spot. Hopefully, you won't need it.
Cool.
Clementine's got the other one. Check in with her and get back here as soon as you can.
And you? What's your name?
It's Lily. My dad's Larry.
Keep a good eye on him. These boys will work on getting you your medicine.
That's right. Mm.
And you? You keep an eye on that front
Even
door.
He was
you're
ass.
Our lookout.
It's Doug. You got it.
And I'm Carly.
Okay, Carly. You'll shift in with Doug when he needs it. For now, get some rest. You're a good shot, and I'd like to keep it that way.
You got it, boss.
Now get him those pills.
So I don't need batteries for that, so instead of wasting my time, I might as well try to find them.
No, I'm sorry to hear your loved one was eaten by the living dead guards.
We can't let anything happen to Ducky.
I know, hon.
I don't remember them very well.
We just need to get back to Fort Lauderdale.
Hey, Lee. Maybe punching him wasn't such a good idea.
There were worse plans.
Says the guy who didn't get punched in the mouth. Anyway, we, Kat and I... appreciate your support.
Thank you, Lee.
Are you guys all right?
We're just fine, considering.
How about you, Duck?
We've all been through a lot.
At least he's quiet now.
How's Duck doing?
He's okay. It was just a shock.
We're lucky as hell nobody got nabbed on the way in here.
No kidding.
How's she doing?
She still hasn't peed yet. This is how she...
She's good, I think.
She's a tough one right there.
She's just a little girl, Ken.
Were you saying, Lee, she spent days surviving on her own?
That's yep. Right.
Not just any little girl can do that.
She was in a treehouse. They can't climb, so...
What's the plan?
Hang tight, I suppose. Seems pretty dangerous out there, so we ought to wait for things to clear up.
You said your family was from here in Macon?
That's right.
Yeah, this is their drugstore.
Where are they? Should we go looking for them?
They own this place. They're gone.
Oh, sweetie.
Cat.
They were good people. I wasn't around much, but yeah, they're dead.
Lee, you got a second?
Sure.
I'm gonna do what I can not to lie to anybody.
Back on Herschel's farm.
Yeah.
We didn't even try to save him. That blood is on our hands, you know?
I tried to. Or wanted to, at least.
It happened pretty fast.
I guess. But I can't stop seeing him in my head.
We can't kill ourselves over.
We killed that boy. We could have saved him together.
We did what we could. Bad things happen. We didn't make a choice that killed Sean. You think you do when you look back on it. But in a moment, when things are really out of control, you don't have any choice.
I guess.
Try to let it go.
Oh, food. Candy bar of some sort.
Try to get some rest, hon.
How can I with those things out there?
Okay. On the floor. Another candy bar.
It's not damaged. Glad this place didn't get looted. Central High Tech State. Paper's a week old. Feels like year.
Alright, let me go in the back room. I think some batteries are in there. You're lucky we're even trying to help you.
What's that?
My dad's cane?
This was my dad's cane.
Yep.
He'd zip around here on it from time to time.
Was he sick?
Nah, he was okay. I actually saw him whoop shoplifters with it. This cane's protected this place better than any guard dog ever could. Plus, he knew how to make it look cool. Like you with your hat.
My dad gave it to me.
See, dads are smart like that. Better get this door clear, huh?
Can I help?
Sure.
My face.
Here we go.
I'm so happy to help.
Put your fingers in the drawers. How are you doing?
Yeah, it's not that heavy.
How about with everything outside?
It's not good.
No, it's not.
But I think it'll be okay.
Okay. Here we go.
She's very positive. That's good.
Do you have kids?
No.
You don't have a family?
What do your parents do?
My mom is a doctor, and my dad is an engineer.
Want to change the subject?
Those are good jobs.
What's your job?
I teach history and writing and things like that.
Like social studies?
Yeah, like that.
You didn't answer my question.
All right, a little further.
No, I didn't.
Why don't you want to talk about your family? Do they, like, hate you?
I hope not. It's just complicated, that's all.
Why?
It just is.
But you love them, right?
Yeah, of course. Look, my family's gone, and I just wish things would have been different.
Yeah.
I got into a fight once.
And what happened?
And it ended really badly. After that, I wasn't allowed to talk to my family.
That's so sad.
Let's move this thing.
Ow!
Be careful, Clem.
I hurt my finger.
Is it bleeding?
A little.
I'll find you a bandage.
Well, okay, I know where there's the first aid kit. No.
Let's have a look at that finger. Ow.
It hurt.
Let's see if we can do something about it. Let's get
bandage.
This cut covered up.
Yes, please. Lee?
Yeah?
What if my parents come home and I'm not there?
They'll find us. Don't worry.
Yeah, okay. We should keep a lookout. I've got my walkie-talkie in case they try that way.
Stay close to me until then, okay?
I'm kind of excited. I think I heard that they're going to be making another episode or another season with Clem being a little older. So that's pretty cool. I hope that's the case.
How's your finger?
It's okay. Thanks for fixing it.
I'm gonna keep looking around.
Okay.
Open this drawer. Take the batteries from the remote.
It's the remote to my dad's TV. It's locked. We need to track down the keys if we're gonna help Larry.
Family. His family.
Find anything?
Just a picture of whoever was here.
I know who you are. You're Lee Everett. You're a professor at Athens who killed a state senator who was sleeping with your wife. This is your parents' store. Folks around town know the owner's son got himself a life sentence, but I'm a reporter for WABE in Atlanta. I paid attention to that trial. Maybe you're a murderer, but I don't really care. Frankly, that's a skill that might come in handy. Did you tell anyone out there who you were, or that you were tied to this place?
The world is ending out there. Who cares who I am?
If you don't think people will find any reason to turn on you, especially when the shit hits the fan, you're insane.
Whatever.
You seem like an okay guy, and the last thing we need is drama out there. You've got this little girl to take care of, and... Look, don't make me wrong on this.
I don't plan to.
Good. Because if this lasts longer than a few days, and you're a detriment to the group, then we'd have a problem.
I hear you.
I'll just keep it to myself.
Damn right you will.
Thanks.
Don't worry about it.
What's up here?
Dad told me he bought that TV to watch baseball in here, but I caught him watching his stories more than a few times. That's what I figured. Wanna head back into the drugstore with me?
Okay. Lee?
Yeah?
You're not bad, right?
Why are you asking me that?
That lady said you killed someone. Was that because he was one of the things trying to eat you?
No, he wasn't.
Oh. Was he bad?
He was.
So if he's bad, he it's okay, apparently. Okay, batteries, they should be inside the remote. So let's... No, that's not what I need. Let's see. I need the remote, I believe, for something coming up soon. There has to be batteries close by. What's in here?
Looks like nobody got a chance to donate anything before this all went down.
I'll just talk to her. I know I need batteries for this, though.
Hey there. This is Glenn, and I'm kinda in a jam here. Little girl, if you're there, can you put your daddy on the phone? Or on the talkie, or whatever?
This is Lee. What's up?
So, I'm down at that Motor Inn, and, well, I'm stuck.
Stuck?
Yeah, I saw a chance to get some supplies for the group, and a bunch of the Roman ones got the jump on me. I'm hiding over here, but they won't leave.
What's up?
Glenn's trapped down at the Motor Inn. Hey, Glenn, we're gonna talk it over and send a group to come get you, all right?
Awesome. I'll sit tight till then.
Sounds good. I'm gonna hold on to this until we get Glenn back, okay? I'll take good care of it.
What do you think?
I think Doug's not great around zombies. You got your family here. I'll take Carly and her dead.
I like how they call them zombies. At least he mentioned zombies now.
As fast as I can.
That's what you want to do.
I don't think they use that word, the word zombie, in the show at all.
Yeah, I'm in.
Good. Doesn't sound too bad there right now.
Let me know as soon as you want to head out. I could use a jog.
Here. I've been finding some stuff to eat.
Oh, thanks.
You're welcome.
Are you sure your girl doesn't need it?
Oh, yeah, she might, I suppose.
Yeah, give it to her. I can take care of myself.
I didn't mean to give her that. Yeah, speaking of that, let me get the food to her and Duck. Even though I hate Duck, he's still a child. He still deserves
not
to
much,
eat it.
But here you go.
Thank you.
Of course.
Where's Duck?
It's not much, but here. For the boy.
Oh, thanks, Lee. He appreciates it.
That's sweet, Lee.
And I do want to get on... What's her name's... good side over here.
How's he doing?
I'm not sure I got your name.
It's Lee.
Lily. My dad's Larry.
Like, with her, it's weird. She seems pissed, like, during one, like, sentence, and then she seems normal on another.
And I'm powerless to do anything. And that violence before with my dad, that didn't help.
You're from here?
I work at Warner Robins. The Air Force base.
Yeah, I know it. Pilot?
Nah, just mechanical admin stuff. I deal with a bunch of shitheads and bureaucrats all day. Sometimes a plane, if I'm lucky. You?
I work up at UGA. What's wrong with him?
He's got a heart condition. He takes nitroglycerin tablets pretty regularly. I've seen a few bad attacks that he couldn't get over and needed to go to the hospital.
Yeah, that's not really an option right now.
I'm just trying to keep him relaxed.
What do you think about all this?
What is there to think? The dead are up, walking around, eating people, and turning them into more of them. I mean, Jesus.
We need to stick together and get through this. Was anyone here when you guys got here?
No, this place was pretty wrecked. We pulled a couple of bodies out of the office. Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Did you know anybody here?
Yeah, the owners, they were, we were close.
I'm sorry. We found an older couple in the office. Dad hauled them out in case they weren't really dead.
He's got a temper.
Ah, fuck you!
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, he doesn't mean it.
It's just that...
Yeah?
Never mind. I'm sure he's a good guy.
He is. He just has his issues. Where's her mom?
Savannah, I think.
Oh, you guys aren't together.
Oh, no, I'm not her dad. I found her in a house when getting out of Atlanta. She'd been surviving by herself. I think the girl's parents didn't make it.
Oh.
I heard an answering message. They were in Savannah. She was home with a sitter. It wasn't good.
Well, she's lucky to have you. I'm gonna get back to him.
Sounds good.
Alright, I guess we'll do the thing with Carly.
You're a pretty good shot.
Well, you don't fuck with a reporter, especially one that's 3 days out from her last cup of coffee.
You seem to handle yourself pretty well.
Really? I'm a disaster.
I can't tell.
My news editor was eaten about 5 feet away from me, and I would have joined her if it wasn't for that dorky guy on watch over there.
I'm sorry.
She was an asshole, but, you know.
Yeah. What are you messing around with there?
A radio. I can't get it to work, though.
Here, let me have a look. There are no batteries in this thing.
What now?
You know that there are no batteries in that thing.
Yeah, of course. I mean, yeah. No.
I can try to find some. Needs two.
Thanks. I wouldn't even really know what to look for.
Okay, let me try to find the batteries real fast. I have a feeling that they should be in here. I know they are. I think... should be here somewhere. Pharmacy I'm trying to get into. Well, let's just head out. I'll find a... Oh, there's one battery. Okay, I did find
this
a battery.
This battery should fit the radio.
Great, thanks.
And here's another one.
Should be able to get it to work now.
Oh, I did have two. Okay.
Hey, Carly. It's still not working?
Yeah, I can't figure it out.
Let me have a look at that thing.
Go ahead.
Oh, the battery's backwards. That's right.
You fixed it.
Continues to spread unchecked. The estimated death toll continues to skyrocket. WABE urges you to stay indoors and avoid any contact with individuals you suspect may have been exposed.
The station is okay.
In the event of a full... My producer's telling me we have to get off the air.
Steve.
Heard or seen anything?
Nothing, luckily. Wanna step outside, have a look around?
I'm not suicidal yet.
No, the gate up there is closed. You can hang out in front of the store and be fine.
Oh, sure. Let's go have a look around.
Cool. And we'll keep it down.
Don't I didn't mean to do that. I want to stay in here.
Unnecessary noises.
Agreed. Jesus.
No!
Just
eat. As far as I can tell, that's all they care about.
And if one gets you,
they eat you. And whatever's left comes back as one of them.
How the fuck?
I think it might be more than a couple days before all this gets sorted out.
Yeah, I think so too. We better keep it down out of here.
That's his brother.
Seconds.
Maybe there's a way to distract them and buy you some time.
Doug, you want to get this door open?
About that.
You've got the combo, right?
No.
Did anyone ever have it?
Look, man, there were a lot of those things trying to get...
Can't reach that brick, it's like a foot. Like moths, they're just like attracted to the light. And I guess the sound of the TV, but still. How can I reach this? How can you not reach that?
I can't reach that brick.
Okay, well, I'm gonna go back inside.
Let's head back inside.
Okay.
Harley, let's go do our thing.
Hey there.
Go save Glenn.
You ready to head out?
You got it. You?
Yeah.
Let's go.
Ben's probably like, what's taking these guys so long?
Get down!
Did you see that?
Sure did. Be ready to shoot.
Guys! Oh, man. I'm glad you're here.
Jesus, Glenn.
Right then wasn't so hard.
Can we get out of here before any of these things notice us?
Not yet. There's a survivor trapped up there.
No way. We gotta go. Now.
Listen, I was out here looking for gas. And then, up there in the corner room, I heard crying coming from inside.
Who is it?
It's a girl. We talked and she got frightened. I was trying to get in and help her and she started yelling and saying I was bitten.
You should actually just leave her.
And that's when all these guys came out of the forest. A couple almost got me. And I ended up hiding in the ice machine.
Lucky you. Now let's go.
We can't just leave her.
Damn right.
Sure we can.
What? You guys are suicidal. Over a girl.
I'm saving her, with or without you.
Think about if it was you.
Fine. Let's go save Glenn's damsel in distress.
No.
Okay, this is the plan. You don't know how hard it's gonna be to get her out of that room.
Yeah, it's boarded up.
So we have to kill every one of them in here. Quietly. Noise attracts these things. Now let's have a look around.
Hey man, that drew some attention. Be careful.
Okay. It was on the left side. I remember what to do now.
Get out your gun.
But the noise.
Just follow my lead. Stay right behind me.
Not sure if that would actually work.
Wait. Let me see the spark plug. The porcelain inside these things turns car windows to tissue paper.
Ugh.
just randomly knows that.
That could scramble a brain pretty good.
That's exactly what I was thinking.
Gonna definitely grab that axe. Well, I guess I have to kill him first. I would give that.
Dude, where'd your weapon go?
I would grab that. I would give that to one of them.
Holy shit. It's cool. Now we've got this.
Are you two done?
Two more.
That should help.
Why don't you guys lag behind just in case this goes to hell?
Okay, we'll be right behind you.
Get him.
Rad.
Rad. Really? Who says rad? Apparently Glenn does.
Hello in there. We're here to help.
Please just go away.
Let's go, guys.
In a minute. If you open up, we can take you somewhere safer. We've got a group in town.
No.
Please. She's in trouble.
No. Miss, we're coming in.
How did they, like, do this? Like, how are they inside? Are they able to nail this thing shut in front of it?
You might want to break through that board first.
Stop! Just stop! I'm coming out. Oh, God. I said stay away.
We need to get you help.
It's too late for that.
Guys, she's been bitten.
What?
I told you, I said go away. I'm bit. But you wouldn't just leave.
Let's calm down. You could be fine.
I won't be fine. My boyfriend was bitten. You get sick and you die and you come back and you kill anything you can find.
You have a boyfriend?
Glenn.
I don't want that.
That's all he cares about.
It's not Christian. Please, just leave me. Please go.
Okay, we'll leave. Just try to take care of yourself for whatever time you have left.
You have a gun.
So?
Can I borrow it?
What do you mean, borrow?
Give it to me. I can just... you know, end this, and then there's no problem.
Whoa.
Please, I don't want to be one of them. They're satanic.
We can't let you do that to yourself.
Then do it for me.
We need to get going.
Give it to me, please.
This is crazy.
Please, step back.
It's just 2 seconds, just one bullet, and I can be with my family, and it'll all be fine.
Yes.
Back up, please!
Whoa, take it easy. We just want to help.
You can't.
Miss, just relax now. You need to think this through. We'll find you a doctor. It'll be okay. Let's all just...
No, no! No!
I mean, she's gonna die anyway. But I guess it doesn't matter. You better leave now before the zombies come, though.
Let's get out of here.
There they go.
Here they come. Oh, just what he said. Here they come.
Get in!
Everyone all right?
Yeah, we had some close calls, but Glenn is fine and... Well, yeah. We're okay.
I've got a few cans of gas for your pickup in the trunk of my car.
Good to hear it.
And things back here?
Quiet. Our friend is still in and out over there. He won't survive any more stress.
The next order of business is getting those pills out of the pharmacy.
So you need the key. I have the axe now, so I can open up... I believe I need the axe to open up that cage door in front. I guess I can give it back her walkie.
Hey there.
Hi.
Can I get you anything?
I'm okay. Maybe I'm a little hungry.
I just gave you a bar.
Yeah, it wasn't much.
I know, Clem. I'll see if I can find something else for you. So,
are you okay?
What? Yeah, I'm fine. I just, I'm good.
That's good.
Yeah, I think so. Being good is good, despite the circumstances.
Yep.
How's your finger, Clem?
Good. It doesn't hurt so much anymore.
Good.
I said good a lot there, really.
I know I'm not your dad, but if you need anything, I'm your guy, okay?
Okay, same.
You're my guy?
Oh, no. You know.
We're gonna try to take care of each other.
Yes, deal.
I don't know. I mean, you guys seem okay.
What about your family?
Yeah,
I do agree it would have been with you, but...
Forget it, man. That's your business.
I hate feeling like I can't do anything.
I know the feeling, man. Do you know the combination for the lock on the gate outside?
Why?
Oh, you know. I thought I'd go stretch my legs.
You're probably better off breaking it if you have to.
Try to get some rest.
Huh. Yeah, right.
Alright, well, break it off with the axe.
How are we doing?
Good. Wanna go have a look around outside?
Let's have a look around.
Okay.
how to distract those things. Carefully.
Those TVs are on, and I'm sure they're making a lot of noise behind that glass. Man, that's a hasty fortification job over there.
Yeah, it didn't work.
Few seconds of searching and we'll know if he has the keys. We should think about searching that guy across the street.
Maybe he has them, but who knows if he actually worked here.
He does tech stuff, and it just made sense.
So you're local. You probably knew the owners of this place.
No, not really.
Well, I'm just looking at his crotch while he's talking.
I spend a lot of time.
On the computer?
No, just doing my own thing. What about you?
I knew some folks here. Seemed like as good a place as any.
Oh, friends? Family? They around?
Family. But it doesn't seem like it. Those TVs are on, and I'm sure they're making a lot of noise behind that glass.
Oh, I need to throw something out. Oh, that's a brick. That's right. I don't remember.
Be careful.
Keep an eye out, will you? Second. I got to do this now, man. I got to do this.
Gotta destroy the brain. Why are you hitting the neck? Hit the head. There you
go.
Holy crap! Run!
The way that made it look like, the way he said holy crap, and then it was so loud that the zombies turned and ran over.
Man, that was close.
But we did it. Got the keys.
Great. God. you're amazing. Let's get there. Gotta hurry. Time to go.
I'm gonna get the truck pulled up round back.
Do it fast. I gotta get my dad out of here.
I don't plan on dilly-dallying. Honey, take Duck
in the office. Dilly-dallying.
Get the living hell out of the door behind me. Glenn, when you hear me honking in the alley, start getting people out of here.
You got it.
Doug, Carly, and Lee, you guys make sure our defenses stay up till then. And Lee, I better take that axe in case I run into any of them on the way to my truck.
Here you go.
Guys, that door's not locked anymore.
Shit.
You three, get on it. I'll get back as fast as I can.
Stay away from the windows.
Glenn, we need your help. Please hurry.
Wait, Glenn, leave.
If we don't make it through this, you should know that I think you're a great guy.
Shut up, Doug.
Doug, if we don't make it through this,
shut up.
You should know.
I should know what?
Huh?
Then I should know.
Shit!
On it.
Are you sure?
Shit!
Shit! Okay then. Clementine, can you look for something to stick in between the handles? Something real strong, okay?
Okay.
Clementine, did you find anything?
Nothing. Wait.
The window is screwed.
Go.
So between these two people, I don't want anyone to die, but I think Carly's been more worthy. Yeah, help Carly. But I still don't understand how I can't, like, do that real fast and run back. I didn't do anything to you. I saved you, actually.
I'm not letting somebody else get eaten today. Especially a good friend.
Stay in their homes, they are urged to be near their radios and await further instructions.
Moving to the cities of Charlotte, Atlanta, or Orlando
up,
may
said.
Become necessary
oh,
in order
oh,
to
maintain the evolved system. It was so awesome.
Meanwhile, inland, Atlanta has been downgraded temporarily to an 8, with attacks and rioting being reported in all precincts. Citizens are currently advised to stay in their homes or move towards the cities of Charlotte, Atlanta, and Orlando.
Hey, Glenn.
With uncountable severe emergencies in all counties, Georgia's cities and their current level of disaster are as follows. Atlanta, stage 9 catastrophe. Augusta, stage 8.
I think I need to go.
Columbus,
to Atlanta.
Yeah, I got friends there. And I just can't stay here knowing that they could be trapped in that city.
Sounds like nobody knows what's happening there. When we left a few days ago, could have gone either way.
I gotta take my chances.
You gotta do.
And I gotta do this.
I respect that.
You guys be safe.
We'll try.
It'd be cool if Glenn comes back in a later series.
Close call back there.
Thanks for picking me up.
No problem. We have to take care of each other.
Yeah, we do.
Hey, about Clementine.
Yeah?
Earlier I said there's some stuff out there that might screw up a precious little girl like her.
You did.
Well, I still think that's true. But after what I saw today, I think between you taking care of her and her taking care of herself... You two are gonna be just fine.
Thanks, Kenny.
You got it.
Did you check the glove box? I swear I saw you. You never pay attention to where you leave things. Can you just look over everything you own?
How you doing, Carly?
I'm okay. You know, considering.
I do, yeah.
I can't stop thinking about Doug. We couldn't have saved him, could we?
I don't think so. It happened pretty fast.
I know it's stupid. We just met. And he was such a... It's just that... I think that I liked him.
You'll be all right.
Yeah. Definitely. Anyway, I'd rather be alone, I think.
I understand.
Wait, Lee?
What is it?
How did you choose? We both needed you. You picked me.
I was gonna help you both.
But you helped me first.
Yeah, I did.
I just wish we both could have made it, you know?
Me too, Carly.
I thought Super Dinosaur was toast. But you know what? He wasn't. Oh, and then...
Hey, Duck, you want to cool it for a minute?
Okay, sorry.
When I say that, I mean shut up and get out of here.
I'm sorry, there's not a lot of kids here.
No, it's not that. It's... I got grabbed again.
I was there, though.
I fell, and my walkie-talkie broke. Glenn had the other one.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Thanks. I know I need to be tough. I'm just sad.
I know it doesn't make any sense, but it's how I used to talk to my mom and dad. And now they're gone. It's gone.
Maybe we can find you another one.
I'll just keep this one, I guess.
Lee, come here for a second.
Let me go deal with this.
Oh, man, Clementine, another thing.
What do you want?
You like my daughter?
She's fine.
Fine, huh? Well, just fuck you, Lee Everett. That's right. I know who you are, and I know you're a killer. And you go near my daughter or step out of line once, and so will everyone else. I know who you are. And I don't give a shit about what happens to you. But if anything happens to my daughter or that little girl you've got with you, you watch your ass.
That's why I'm going to tell everybody the truth,
Lee,
so you don't have any
hold
over me.
My dad would be dead if it weren't for you.
That guy Doug is dead because of me.
You can't be like that. You're only one man.
I don't know.
We're lucky to have you.
I hope that's the sound of us winning this thing.
Me too.
This motor inn's pretty damn defendable. We block off the entrances with some cars, keep someone on watch. We could stay here until the military rolls through.
I actually agree with that plan.
Me too.
We got beds, we got water, and most importantly, we got light. They're worse places to call home.
Yeah, you're right. You know, guys, I think it's going to be okay.
Nope, lights are going out. Alright, so chapter one. Chapter one's complete. Or episode one, whatever, however they called it.
I thought we'd be fine if we survived the walkers. Never expected they'd starve us out.
I want you to have this, okay? In case you or Clementine starts feeling weak.
You don't owe me anything, Carly. How you doing, Clementine?
I'm really hungry, Lee.
We gotta get food, Lee. Soon.
Howdy. I'm Andrew St. John. We're from the St. John Dairy.
It's beautiful.
I never did thank you for saving Duck from the walkers back at Herschel's farm.
Something's coming, Lee. There's gonna be a war.
The walkers don't worry me as much as the bandits.
There we go.
Now we're gonna take what we want! There's too many of them!
Alright, so I lied to Herschel, so I didn't lie. I guess it was honesty. I didn't lie to Herschel. I don't understand why it says I lied. I was truthful the whole entire time. Who would you save, Duck or Sean? The only reason I choose Duck was because I know I had Kenny on my team. I sided with Kenny. If I read the guy. And people choose Doug over Carly? I don't know, I think Carly's more reliable over Doug. Alright, that's chapter one, episode one. I think I'm gonna do another video later with episode two. Great playing with everyone.